Hello, and welcome to this episode of the Tool Belt Podcast, brought to you by Plant Services. I'm Tom Wilk, Chief Editor of Plant Services, and for today's episode, we have joining us Mike McCizek, a reliability specialist who checks in with us from time to time. In this episode, Mike talks to us about what the industry landscape looks like in 2021 as we're just starting to emerge from the COVID-19 pandemic.
So, you know, when we were setting this up last week, Mike, we talked a little bit about how industry looks these days, and you had mentioned that as far as manufacturing goes, industry's kind of reached this new normal where COVID-related delays and hiccups are now pretty much baked into operations. Can you talk a little bit about how your workplace has adjusted in this way?
Yes, so it's a normal now to clean all the doorknobs, push bars, doors, and everything with antibacterial and ammonia-based products to keep the virus away. We still do temperature checks at the doors. We social distance and we wear masks. That's just become part of the thing now. It's a new normal. You don't even think about it anymore. Everyone just does it. So we're keeping up the pace because I know it's not as prevalent as it was, but it's still out there. So you just got to think about what you're doing all the time. And other than that, it's the same.
Can you talk about how other plants have adjusted? I know you've got friends in like food and pharma, and I was curious to know if you're hearing that things are different based on the kind of plant you're working in, whether things are sort of in a new normal.
Yeah, everything's a new normal now. When we talked before, we talked about how we were adjusting to everything. And now I have friends all across every industry, and it's just business as usual, but you're wearing a mask, you're wearing gloves, and you're wiping down everything, and you're just keeping your distance. It's just become the new norm. And maybe it will change, maybe it won't change later, but it's baked in everybody now, and that's just what you do.
Interesting. We had people on the survey last year tell us that they thought they would get back to normal within a year. And I got to admit, I was a little skeptical about that, but this is interesting to hear that these little hiccups are pretty much baked into the process.
Yeah, we don't dwell upon it anymore. We just do it like a normal thing anymore. So whatever changes back to normal, that'll probably take a while to go back to the old way.
Sure. Well, you know, something I do keep hearing that is still kind of a challenge is supply chain and spare parts. I was at the virtual Marcon conference last week, and a couple of folks have reported that lead times especially are tough to deal with because they're pretty long these days, longer than usual, and they may stay that way. What's your experience with supply chain issues coming out of COVID?
Supply chain right now is bad. Yeah, your lead times are long, and if you're trying to run a lean plant, you're going to have a real hard time because now you're getting things for inventory, so you have them. You can't wait till the last second anymore and get it right in because that won't work. You may wait. I know I've ordered some stuff, and it took 6 weeks where it used to take 3 days. So the new normal is keeping inventory. Got to keep an inventory now unless you're going to shut down the line and you'll be dead in the water until you get a part or figure out a way around it. And then once you start thinking OEM stuff around, anything's possible.
You know, the folks who mentioned this supply chain issue were mostly worked in planning and scheduling. It was in a session on planning and scheduling. I'm curious, at your facility, do you guys have planners and schedulers who are seeing this kind of thing?
Yes, we have planners and schedulers, and we have someone who just tries to order parts all day long. That's how it becomes. Even light bulbs, industrial light bulbs, it can be an issue. They're all on back order right now. So when you get to that level where you can't light up your plant, you're kind of in trouble.
Wow. As a consumer, when I go to Target, I see bacterial wipes on the shelf. I see toilet paper available. You know, so at this point, that kind of consumer supply chain seems to be in place. So this is interesting that you mentioned this because anybody who works in the industry, of course, would see it. But people like me wouldn't necessarily.
So. Yeah, even like I go to Walmart or wherever, And
yeah.
the shells have stuff on them, but they're not like they used to be. They be filled.
Yeah.
Now they're just stuff on the shelves. And they manipulate things around so it looks like they have product, but it's nothing
mm-hmm.
like it was last year.
Right. Well, I got two more questions. One of them is on 3D printing. I remember this time last year, the 3D printers and the makerspaces, they really came to the rescue of industry and especially in medicine. When they went into overdrive, creating masks and especially face shields. And I heard some stories about plants sort of retooling their product line to help with this emergency stuff. I'm curious, you know, when it comes to this kind of emergency retooling, has supply on this stuff caught up with demand, especially on the stuff that 3D printers were pitching in? Or do you still
yes,
see plants?
I see the parts. There's a piece they make for the back of your the back of your face masks. They're everywhere now. I see the face shields everywhere. Everybody that retooled, I think we've caught up because I could go to Walmart, Target, or wherever, and they're there. A couple
mm-hmm.
months ago, you had to be there when they got there because they didn't even get stuff on the shelves. It was in the boxes and it was gone.
Yeah.
So I don't see a problem with that anymore at the moment.
It
but
wasn't that long ago. Yeah.
Yep, and it can change quick. So there could be a rebound or something could happen, and then all of a sudden it's catch up. But we're tooled.
Yep.
Everybody's tooled up now, so they can. If the demand is there, they can keep up with the supply. The PPE part is not that bad, Tom. It's the other thing, like parts for your machinery.
Like the parts for the machines or stuff that you're talking about that's related to COVID?
No, I'm talking about other things now out of COVID because everybody. Trying to half their line may be COVID stuff and the other half may be making parts. So making
mm-hmm.
parts become second burner. And then
mm-hmm.
they're trying to catch up and everybody's trying to catch up and it's rough.
You're
I mean,
right.
I heard my one friend went to get a refrigerator and he's still waiting. They're on back order. And I never heard of a refrigerator being on back order before.
Yeah, normally they gotta give you a discount to get it out the door. That's incredible.
Yeah, now you can't get one. So, which drives the price up also because when it becomes the supply and demand, of course, when there's no supply and there's a lot of demand, the price rises because that's just the way it happens. Like you said,
wow.
There's not 100 refrigerators laid around on the floor. I watch
wow.
people buy right off the floor, actually.
So, I do have one last question. And, you know, Plant Services is going to continue to cover COVID on occasion as it pops up, but you know it does feel like we're sort of moving slowly out of the crisis. We see an endpoint of that itself. Do you have any thoughts, any final thoughts for the podcast on what it means to be sort of 1 year out from the start of this? You know, what is new normal for you?
Well, the new normal is what we're doing now. Will we ever go back to the old normal? I think we will, but when, I don't know, because now you have mutations and all this other stuff starting to pop out. We just got to hang in there and keep the faith. There's nothing more we can really do. Basically, like I said in the first one, wash your hands, try to wear gloves, face mask, shield if you have one, and keep your distance. And pretty much that's what you can do.
All right. Hey, thank you once again for checking in with us, especially since it's been a year since everyone sort of went on lockdown. And I really do hope that we get to see each other again in person second half of the year, I'm guessing, at some sort of professional event once those go live again. Thanks, Mike, for talking today.
You're welcome. Thanks for having me, Tom.